Zahak, the legendary serpent king from Persian mythology that was corrupted by an evil spirit and cursed with monstrous snakes growing from each of his shoulders. He oversaw a reign of terror and oppression that seemed unending. Who was this devilish king, and could he ever be defeated? Let's find out together right now. Zahak was born as the son of a Persian ruler named Murdas. He was a handsome and clever prince, but easily swayed with no real conviction or strength of character. The perfect target then for the evil spirit Ahriman, the devil of Persian mythology. With the ability to change his form at will, Ahriman appears to the young prince as a flattering companion, earning his trust and friendship over time, and eventually convincing Zahak to kill his own father so that he may inherit the kingdom. Zahak, unaware that he is being manipulated so callously, digs a deep pit in the gardens where his father would pray each morning and covers it with leaves. Murdas falls into the pit and is killed, and with no hint of suspicion on him, Zahak inherits the kingdom and becomes its ruler. Not content with his work, Ahriman next appears as a marvelous cook and presents Zahak with many days of incredible feasts until the new ruler is willing to grant him any boon he wishes. The devil in disguise asks only permission to kiss Zahak twice, once on each of his shoulders. His request is granted, but the very moment the cook's lips touch the second shoulder of Zahak, he completely disappears. Immediately, two black snakes grow from his shoulders, and he cries out in shock and alarm. Zahak demands the snakes be cut from his body, but each time they are severed, they grow back immediately. Really getting into his stride now, Ahriman returns again to the king, but this time disguised as a skilled physician who advises Zahak that there is no way to remove the snakes completely, and that all he can do is attempt to soothe them by satisfying their hunger with a stew made from two human brains every day. Zahak eventually agrees and each day commands his agents to seize two people from the population and execute them so that their brains can be fed to the snakes. As you can imagine, he was not the most popular of rulers by this point. Now, well and truly under the influence of Ahriman and his many forms, Zahak is convinced to wage a war against Jamzid, the ruler of the world's greatest empire that had recently lost the divine grace of God after becoming too arrogant. Zahak builds a great army and hunts Jamzid for many years, eventually capturing him and sawing him in half, taking command of his huge kingdom and cementing himself in a position of absolute power, despite remaining unwittingly under the influence of the devil, of course. The tyranny of Zahak continues for many centuries, his legend born of terror and hate growing every day as his power remains beyond contestation. One night, he has a nightmare where visions of three warriors attacking him haunt his sleep. The youngest warrior knocks him down with a mace and carries him off towards Mount Damavand as a large crowd follows. Upon waking, Zahak shouts so loudly that the palace walls shake and crumble. He summons wise men and scholars from across the land to interpret his dream, and eventually learns that it was a vision of his downfall at the hands of a man named Feridun, wielder of the mace. He dispatches agents across the kingdom to hunt down this enemy, and soon learns that Feridun is but a baby being nourished on the milk of the marvellous cow Barmiyeh. His soldiers trace the location of the cow, but by the time they arrive, the boy and his mother have already fled. They kill the cow, but return with their mission unsuccessful. Zahak lives the next few years in constant fear of this mystery boy. Such is his anxiety that he writes a document testifying to the virtue and righteousness of his kingdom, and demands it is certified by the elders and social elite, in the hope it will convince Feridun there is no need to attack. Most are coerced into signing the document, but one man, a blacksmith named Carver, refuses, given that all of his sons but one had already been sacrificed to the snake. He tears up the document and marches from the court, raising the flag of rebellion and rallying as much support as he can. He travels to the mountains to find Ferodin and convinces the now young man that he must lead an army against Sahak and end his reign of terror once and for all. Ferodin agrees and crafts a mace with an ox's head, raising a huge army from the discontented population and marching to the capital to face Sahak. The king, however, has already fled, but following a short walk, Ferodin comes face to face with Sahak. He strikes him down with his mighty mace, but does not kill him. Instead, on the advice of an angel, he binds him and drags him to a cave underneath Mount Damavand, just as in the dream, where he imprisons the Serpent King, tying him with a lion's pelt fixed with great nails into the walls of the cavern. There, Sahak remains until the end of the world. Thus, the kingdom is freed from centuries of oppression, and Ferodin becomes a symbol of justice and freedom in Persian mythology, remaining so until this very day. A classic tale of good versus evil that touches on many elements of human weakness and how the promise of power can corrupt, but that ultimately ends as a tale of freedom and the strength of unification against a great evil. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more great stories. Cheers.